In this video, I will demonstrate how to extract subsequences from whole genome sequences. The different steps will be illustrated using this demonstration database containing 97 sequence read sets of Staphylococcus aureus with calculated de novo assemblies. The whole genome sequences are stored in the sequence type de novo. We will look for the 7 housekeeping genes as used in the online MLST scheme hosted at mlst.net. The MLST online plugin is already installed in this demonstration database, resulting in a sequence experiment type for each housekeeping gene that is present in the online MLST scheme. Installing a plugin is done in the plugin dialog. The green V sign indicates that the plugin is already installed in this database. One entry is present in my database with a sequence linked to each housekeeping gene experiment. These sequences correspond to the online allelic sequence with allele number 1 and will be used as query sequences when screening our other entries in the database. First, I will install the sequence extraction plugin in this database. I call the plugin dialog. And select the sequence extraction plugin from the list in the Utilities tab. I press the Activate button and confirm the installation of the plugin. Now that the plugin is installed, I need to specify some settings before I can extract the sequences. I go to Analysis, Sequence Types, Extract Sequences, and then Settings. I press the Add button and select De Novo as my origin experiment type. This experiment contains the whole genome sequences that will be used for the screening. I will check all 7 housekeeping gene experiments for the storage of the extracted sequences. In the next step, I select my reference entry from the list of entries in the database. This entry contains the query sequences for each housekeeping gene. I will use the default suggested BLAST settings in this exercise and press Next. The tree is updated. Optionally, the report settings can be modified. I press OK to close the wizard. I can now start the actual sequence extraction process. I select all entries in my database using the Ctrl+A keyboard combination and I unselect my query sequence. I now select Analysis, Sequence Types, Extract Sequences, Analyze to start the extraction process. A progress bar appears. When the analysis is finished, a dialog is displayed. I select Yes to call the report window. This window displays a summary of the extraction results. The entries included in the search are displayed in the Entries panel. The results of the highlighted entry are displayed in the panel on the right. The destination experiments are displayed in the first column. The second column displays whether or not a blast hit was found. More information about the blast results can be found in the other columns. I can close the report window, and I can call it back at any time with the menu option, Analysis, Sequence Types, Extract Sequences, Show Reports. The extracted sequences are stored in the destination experiments indicated with green colored dots in the Experiment Presence panel. Clicking on a green colored dot of one of the destination experiments will open the sequence editor displaying the extracted sequence.